Assalamu alaikum.
Please turn your camera off, if you don't mind. Okay, thank you. So what do you like to say to us? Wa alaikum assalam.
Can you speak Arabic?
A little. Alaikum salam. Alaikum salam.
If I speak Arabic, would you understand me?
It's going to be very hard for me because I'm from the Punjab.
You are from what?
Punjab. Punjab.
India.
Oh yeah. I was eating curry just now. What do you want to say to me, my friend? You speak English very fine. Don't worry about it. Go ahead.
I would like to ask you about something. I have seen it yesterday.
Okay.
About the verses in Quran ayah.
Okay, you are a Muslim, right?
Yes, I am Muslim.
Okay, what is the verse?
Do you know the ayah, it says inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala an-nabi.
Okay.
The word of yusallun in Arabic.
What about it? You tell me what does that mean?
You understand me what I
say? I understand. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Yusallun in Arabic, you have translated it salute in English or in French.
Really? Who said that to you?
You.
I did? No, I did not. I never do that.
You in your video yesterday, I have seen it that you have translated it to salute.
No, I said the pray and salute because the verse saying that the
yes,
pray
salute.
And salute. Yes, salute is salute is different word. It's not the word pray. Salute is different word. So,
but the correct word is pray, not salute.
My friend, how I can say pray without salute? Because the verse. You are the one who quote the chapter for me, right? It says there that Allah and His Messenger, Allah and His angels, they pray on Muhammad and salute him. Not only salute him, not only pray for him. So you have to mention two things at the same time.
Wait. Tell me, please, the word of salute, what does it mean?
Say shalom.
Shalom. It's in Herb language, but the right word is pray, not salute.
No, my friend, the verse in the verse you quote from
in Arabic. In Arabic,
my friend, what's your name?
My name is Najib. I'm from Algeria.
Okay, Najib, my friend, the verse you quote for me, it says two things. It says you saloon and it says salute. So it's not doesn't say one word. There's two words. Read the verse for me again.
Yusallun.
Yeah, it says two words. It says yusallun and it says they say shalom. It says shalom. Two words and not only one. Let me read for you. I will try to fix my Arabic so you can read with me. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala an-nabiyya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. So you see here it says that innal malaika yusallun, the angels they pray, and then Allah, He says to them, all those who believe, sallu alayhi, pray on Him. And then at the end, He says, wasallimu taslima, which means, and salute Him, great salute. So it is two things, not only one. You have to do salah and you have to do salute, correct? Okay, now I want to ask you, as long as a Muslim you are, how Allah He pray on Muhammad?
By mercy. In our Arabic,
yeah, but
language,
Allah is God. He pray to whom?
To pray of Allah is it means that mercy.
Pray mean mercy? What I don't understand.
The word of mercy.
No, my friend, in Arabic, mercy is rahma.
Yes, rahma.
You see, I'm learning Arabic right now. So the word rahma is mercy. So Allah, if you want to say rahma, He would say rahma, but He'd not say. He said yusalli. Yusalli mean to pray.
Allah yusalli al-Nabi ma'naha rahma. Rahma min Allah al-Nabi.
Okay, hold on. If Allah, He do salah, that means Allah, He make mercy in the Prophet, correct?
What?
If you are saying to me, when Allah, He says he do salah, He is giving Muhammad mercy.
Salah, you understand me when I speak Arabic?
Little, because my Arabic is broken.
Salat. Okay, I will tell you in Arabic. Salat min Allah ala al-Nabi ma'naha rahma min Allah.
Okay, mercy from Allah, no problem. But this is mean,
yes,
that but that that's mean the mercy.
This is the right word.
Okay, no problem. But here, I will change what the verse is saying, and make it mercy, as you said. So here, in the Muslim translation, they say blessing. I will make it mercy. Okay. So Allah and the angels, they give mercy, and then Allah is asking the believers to ask Allah to give him mercy. Is that correct?
Repeat this, please. My English is not enough good.
Let me say it to you in Arabic. Allah wa malaikatahu يعطون الرسول رحمة.
No, not given. ليس يعطون. إن الله وملائكته يصلون. الله يعطي الله الصلاة هنا بمعنى الرحمة.
Okay, make it to me in sentence then. Okay, رحمة. How we can make رحمة? رحمة is what? رحمة to eat. رحمة to cook. رحمة to send. What? إن الله وملائكته do what?
Rahmat, it means here by send.
Okay, so send rahma, right? They send down the rahma. That's wonderful. But this is mean that rahma and mercy is coming from the angels too. This mean angels are gods and Allah is God, because both of them they send rahma.
Rahma here from Allah.
No, it says Allah and the angels. They are doing what? One act, yusallun. Both of them they do the same act in the same time.
What do you want to say,
my friend? The translation is false, because you know you speak Arabic, and the word yusalli always mean pray, never been rahma. That's a lie. Secondly, as long the angels and Allah, both of them, they are doing rahma, that's mean all of them they are equal and able to do the same, which means sending mercy. So how the angels can send mercy, and if Allah he sent mercy to Muhammad already, who need the angels anyway? So if Allah, he said to you, mercy to you, rahmah to you, Muhammad Najib. So he sent you rahmah, who need the angels? And why he's asking the believers to ask for more rahmah? I mean, this is silly. Allah, he already sent you rahmah. How many kilograms of rahmah you want?
It's unlimited.
I know what unlimited mean. If God sent me blessing already, there's nothing is called unlimited. That's it. I get the blessing of God. God, he blessed me. It's not about kilograms. What unlimited is that? Is that like, is that about money? Is that about how many blessing we count? This is not smart. If God, he blessed me, I'm blessed. This is not money, my friend. God, he blessed me. God, he blessed you. That it's over. I'm blessed. That's it. Sending more blessing is stupid, because I'm blessed already.
So what do you want to say?
What I want to say, that Muhammad here is saying it clearly, that he is, and the whole universe is busy about him. Allah, the angels and the believers, they are doing one thing. They are praying for him.
Please, can you explain it in Arabic?
Allah wal malaika kulluhum wal mu'minin wa kulluhum yaqumuna bi amalin wahid wa huwa as-salatu ala rasul. Hada yani anna Muhammad asbaha markazul alam. فالكل مهتم به الله والملائكة ومن في السماء ومن في الأرض ومن الجن ومن البشر كله مهموم ومشغول بالصلاة على محمد ابن عبد الله.
نعم لأنه خاتم الأنبياء.
Okay, so he agreed, guys, that Allah and the angels and the believers and everybody, even the genie, all of them, they are praying in Muhammad. And why he said? Because he is the last prophet. So what if you are the last prophet? Why Allah? Allah, you have nothing to do except praying for Muhammad.
What?
لماذا يصلي الله على محمد؟ محمد إذا كان هل ضمنت له الجنة أم لن تضمن له الجنة؟ لماذا يريد يصلي عليه؟ أو هو الله إن قال الله أمرا كن فيكون. فإذا نعم. إذا كان الله قد صلى على محمد وباركه انتهى الأمر، لا داعي لصلاة الملائكة، وليس هناك داعي لأن يسأل المؤمنون بالصلاة على محمد.
أنا I am as Muslim, I believe in that Allah sent his mercy to our Prophet Muhammad.
What is the mercy of your Prophet Muhammad? Muhammad did not have any mercy of his God, because let me show you. Your Prophet, he died by poison and he was suffering badly. Where is the mercy of Allah? Did Muhammad, ألم يموت محمد بالسم? Okay, so he died by poison. Okay, what is the mercy of Allah? Is it from the mercy of Allah that Muhammad will die by poison?
Well, I repeat it in Arabic.
هل من الرحمة أن يسمح الله أن يموت رسوله بالسم؟ هل هذا موت الرحيم؟
السم كان سبب من الأسباب.
This is not the question. هذا ليس السؤال يا صاحبي. هذا ليس السؤال. هل من الرحمة أن يترك رب المسلمين محمد يموت بالسم؟ هل هذا رحمة؟ تتقطع مصارينك وتتألم لفترة طويلة. Is that a mercy that your God he allow such a death, horrible death for Muhammad, taking him years suffering from poison he ate in Khaybar? Is that the mercy of Allah? Here we go. All of you are Muslims are praying for Muhammad. Allah he prayed for Muhammad, angels pray for Muhammad, and the Muslim pray for Muhammad, and yet Muhammad died by poison.
But everyone in this life have to die.
No, that's not true. When the Jews they tried to kill Jesus according to Islam, Allah he took him up to heaven, right?
I don't understand very well.
حينما أراد اليهود أن يقتلوا عيسى رفعه الله إليه صحيح؟
نعم.
Okay. إذن المسيح رحم من الموت ومن القتل ومن التعذيب. محمد ولكن مات وعذب شر ميته.
But in Islam that Jesus Christ peace be upon him will return in last
time. Doesn't matter. The Jews could not kill him, and nobody was able to kill him. Your prophet he died by poison. اليهود لم يقتلوا المسيح ولم يستطيعوا عليه وسوف يعود كملكا حاكما عادلا في هذه الأرض. أي أنه سوف يعود بالشرف والعظمة. وليس كمحمد الذي قتل
ولكنه سيذوق طعم الموت.
ما في مشكلة إذا كان سوف يذوق طعم الموت لكنه لم يموت كالفار بالسم. أين الرحمة؟ يعني أنتم you pray to محمد non-stop day and night. First of all, محمد is dead. What the point? Secondly, محمد he died by poison. So your prayer did not work and Allah blessing is not working. And here we need to ask ourselves, why Allah he protected Isa from death but he did not protect Muhammad from dying by poison? As long you are Allah the angels and the believer they pray for Muhammad and yet he died by poison. Isa nobody pray for him and nobody asked for a mercy for him, and yet according to Islam Allah took him up to heaven. Don't you see there's a contradiction?
It's your opinion.
No, it's not my opinion. This is a fact. The Jews, they wanted to kill Isa. Allah, he took him up to heaven. He did not allow it. The Jews wanted to kill Muhammad. They killed Muhammad, and they killed him by poison. And Muhammad is suffering, as you see. I feel sorry for him. If I am there now, I will give him some zucchini. So you're a prophet. He died a very horrible death. Imagine you live for 5 or 4 years, and there is knives inside your body and cutting you off. How much painful it is. So where is the mercy? You pray to Muhammad, mercy Allah, mercy on Muhammad Allah, mercy. We pray, Allah he pray, the angels they pray, you pray, everybody pray, the rabbit they pray, the genie they pray, the angels they pray, the cats they pray for Muhammad, and yet Muhammad he died in such a way. So where is the prayer going?
I believe I am as a Muslim. I believe in everything what Allah said in holy book Quran.
Okay, let me ask you, my friend. Do you have what is your education?
I am an engineer.
That's wonderful. I like to be in. You know, I wanted to register as an engineer, but they refused me. They said to me, "You have to have elementary school."
I would
first.
Like to ask you something.
Yeah.
When you are not Arabic, when did you learn Arabic?
You know what happened? Jibreel, he came to me and he squeezed me 3 times. And he said to me, "Iqra," and then since then I start reading Arabic.
Please, can you repeat it in
Jibreel, Atani Jibreel, Amsakani, wa Asarani, 3 times. Bad connection. Are you there, Najib? Hello, Najib. Are you there? Hello? I don't know, it looked like we lost him. Let him call me back. Yeah, how you learn Arabic, huh? Jabril, he squeezed me 3 times. Call me back, Najib, if you are hearing me, if you got your connection back. Your God, he squeezed Muhammad 3 times, and he said to him, read. And you Muslim, you pray for mercy of Muhammad. Isn't it mercy to teach him how to read at least? And instead of praying Muhammad, Allah pray on Muhammad, what about Allah? He take him to school for 2 weeks so he can learn how to write his name. That would be better mercy. Don't give me a fish, teach me how to fish. That is a mercy. You have a clear proof that Muhammad is a false man. Why? The angel came to him and he squeezed him 3 times. And after 3 times squeezing, and the angel said to him, read, which is the word of Allah. Yet Muhammad, he cannot read. This is a proof that Muhammad is a false prophet and Allah is a false God. For Allah is, if he is God, and he said to Muhammad, read, even if he is a crocodile, the crocodile will read. What kind of God? He squeezed a man 3 times and say to him, read, and he's angry, read, read, and the guy can't breathe, you know, he can't breathe 3 times, and yet Muhammad cannot read. Jesus said to the blind man, see, he saw. The man, he cannot walk, he carry his bed, and he run with it. Your God, he said to Muhammad, read. And he squeezed him 3 times. I don't know why, not 4. You know what? I think Allah, he made a mistake. If he squeezed him 4 times, I think the Pepsi will come and the mayonnaise will go up. I remember once I went to a restaurant and the mayonnaise was like old. So I squeezed 3 times, nothing came. 4, did it work? So I think Jibreel, he made a mistake when he squeezed him only 3 times. By the way, according to Islamic tradition, look like you cannot be a prophet unless you've been activated by squeezing 3 times. Look like it. It's proven in front of us. Suddenly the angel, he called him the truth, descended upon him while he was in the cave of Hira. The angel come to him and said and asked him to read. The prophet replied, I do not know how to read. The prophet added, the angel cut me forcefully and he pressed me so hard to the point I cannot bear it no more. Okay, what this is about? Here you will notice something very fishy about this story. A man, because the angel here, he came to him as a man. Imagine you are sitting in a place where in the middle of nowhere, and suddenly a man appears in front of you, and then he says to you, read, and then he starts squeezing you. Either he is a gay or he's a crazy. And I should fight him back. Do you see Muhammad saying to him, stop touching me? No. Why? Why Muhammad don't say to him, who are you first? Okay, the guy came to me from the middle of nowhere and said to me, read. Shouldn't I ask, who are you? The man, he started squeezing you. Shouldn't you say, stop touching me? Are you a gay or what? Don't you defend yourself? A man is squeezing you. What does that mean? Unless Muhammad, he like it. And you know, I learned, and this is a proving, I think, by science. Scientifically proven, scientifically. That is squeezing. Yes, Najib. Are you there? Are you there, my friend? His connection is bad. It's a proven by a scientist from Japan. His name is Yama Squeeze Yama, very well known, that if you squeeze a man 3 times, he will become a prophet. Try it. Tomorrow, if you go in the street, in the road, anyone you meet, squeeze him 3 times. But be careful, you have to squeeze very hard. Not just like squeeze, like, you know, you have to really press so hard. Squeeze him 3 times and tell him read. And remember, he have to say, I do not know how to read. If you squeeze someone he knows how to read, that will not work. So he have to be an idiot who do not know how to write, how to read. And you have to squeeze him 3 times and say to him the password, read. And then you will see that this guy will have a greater future. He will become a prophet, and he is a Muslim prophet. And this is from the mystery of Allah, that he squeezed people to make them prophet. Any Muslim have an objection for the squeezing part? You know, always I wanted to squeeze the Prophet Muhammad, but I was afraid to be accused of to be from San Francisco or something. I wonder now if we put Muhammad on a square of a city, big city, and let us say to the Muslims, how many of you want to squeeze him? Shabir Ali will be there. Zakir, let us call Zakir Naik. Should we call Zakir Naik, or Zakir Naik will sue me now because it's too late? He called the police. He told them that there's a sexual harassment, because I call him always after the middle of the night. Hello? Are you there, Najib? Hello?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, Najib. How are you, my friend?
I am always Najib,
I want to ask you, why the angel
is... Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, wa alaikum assalam, Najib. I hear you. Wa alaikum assalam. Najib.
Fine, thanks.
Okay, why...
So, I would like...
Go ahead.
Question bar.
Huh?
Do you hear me?
Say again. Okay, what you said?
My connection is bad. Do you hear me?
I understand. It's okay. You know, this is what happened when Muslims, they steal internet. What happened? Yeah, go ahead.
Connection is bad.
I understand. I understand. Okay. Yeah, what do you want to say? Well, Najib, you need to stop using the internet of your neighbor. You have to purchase your own.
I would like to ask you, where is your,
where what?
Are you, I would like to ask, are you originally Arabic?
To be honest with you, my mother and my father, they used to hijack airplanes. So when my mother gave birth to me, it was like flying all over because the airplane was rejected by many airports. So you can say I'm a black, a blonde African from Japan. Black, a blonde African from Japan. That's a true story. Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 222, Yama, Idu La Yama. He is worried now. Where is this guy? Why he's speaking Arabic very well? If he is not an Arab, I mean, how would that happen? It's a miracle. Here we go. The angel, he squeezed me 3 times. But what happened? I broke his arms after he did that.